students. I am Asmudullah from GK Jain Schools. Today, we are going to continue the third chapter, production analysis. And today, we are going to take the theme of law of supply. See, this law of supply is a very, very important chapter. It's a very, very important topic, not just for your 11th standard portion, but also for your 12th standard, also for your higher study if you are continuing in the commerce field. This law of supply is very, very essential for a day-to-day aspect. If you, in a future when you become the business personality, this law of supply will help you for the various aspects for your production analysis. Let's see the meaning of law of supply. It describes the direct relation between the price of goods and the supply of that good. So, it is nothing but a relationship between the price of the goods and the supply of the goods. So, I am having a 500 quantity of apple means, 500 quantity of apple means, that 500 quantity of apple, how much the rupees is and how much the supply is. For example, if the price of the commodity is high, the supply will be high because I am the producer, I am manufacturing something. For example, I am having the automobile industry. For that reason, I am having different variety of car. For example, I am doing the Maruti Suzuki Swift as my business, and when I do the business, when I increase my price, the supply will be increasing. Then only I will get the profit. Easy to understand. Simply you understand that you are the owner of the business. Example, you are doing the hotel industry business. When you are doing the hotel industry business, when your rate for the food will be high, the profit will be high for you, isn't it? Logical aspect. So that's what I say. It is the direct relation. See here, in a simple aspect, it is the direct relation between what? Price of goods and supply of that good. So, it's a relation between price of good and supply of good. When the price goes up, supplies goes up. When price goes down, supplies go down. Simple way. Let's go back to our class, previous classes, when we have learned about the law of demand. When the prices increases, demand decreases. When demand increases, price reduces. So, in the same way, the law of supply means, in a demand, what happened? When do you have the extra demand, mean price should get down. The price is less means the people will come more and buy. But in the supply, when the price is high only, you will sell the product very effectively. In a simple way, let's understand. It simply explains the relationship between price of commodity and the supply of that commodity. So, it's a relation between what? Price of that commodity and supply of a commodity. For example, I am having the orange business. Orange business I am having. Here is the price and here is the supply. When supply is 10, when the price is 10, the supply is 100. Right? When it is 100, it is 1000. When it is 1000, it will be 10,000. So, when there is an increase in the price, there is an increase in supply. Increase in price, increase in supply. Increase in price, increase in supply. Suddenly what happens, the price is 900, so it will also come down 9,000. So, it's a relationship between how the price increasing, how the price is and how the product is supplied. If the price is high, product supply will be high because you are the manufacturer. You are creating the product. We are not studying now as a buyer. We are not a buyer now. We are the seller. We are selling the product. When you are selling the product, you will assume the profit. You will not see the benefit of the person. You will not see the benefit of consumer, but you will see the benefit of yourself. So, as a predictor, as a producer, what you say? If the price is high, my supply will be high. My supply will be high, my profit will be high. Easy to understand? Simple, in one line you write. This one line will fetch you 2 marks. Law of supply is nothing but a simple relationship between price of commodity and the supply of that commodity. A relationship between supply of the commodity with the price of the commodity. Price of commodity and the supply of that commodity. Okay? In example way, understand, I am having the cloth business. Okay? So, when my cloth rate is increasing, my business of cloth get increasing. For example, I am having a 10,000 rupees per day income for the price for the selling of cloth. When I increase my price, 15,000 per day I'm earning means the supply will be increasing. For 10,000 I have sell around more than 100 piece. For 15,000 I will be selling what? Around 1200 piece 1300 piece or 1500 piece. So that when there is an increase in price, there is an increase in supply. In the law of demand, what happened? Price increases means demand decreases, because as when you increase the price, the people in the market, the consumer will not come and buy. But here, when you increase the price, your supply will be very, 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 because you are the producer. You will think of your own benefit. That's the reason. Simple relationship between price of commodity and the supply of that commodity. Let's understand the supply function. Okay, the supply of commodity depends upon the factors. So the supply of the commodity, so the supply of a product, supply of commodity means something, a product or goods. The supply of goods depends upon, it depends upon, it is there, it's a linkage between what factors, such as price of the commodity. So when there is a supply of your goods, it is because of price of commodity. So the goods product, the price of the product is a reason. Price of the labor, how much your labor is charging. Price of the capital, how much the capital price you have. Price of the technology and the number of firms you have, related goods you have, future goods you have. So when you are having the supply, when the supply is doing, it is because of various factors like price of the product. When the price of the product is good, the people will come and supply will have more effective. The price of the labor, your labor will be charging less and you will have the extra supply, you will have the extra benefit. The capital, the capital investment will be done in a perfect and appropriate way, so you can earn the extra benefit. Technology, you will use the many innovative ideas, many innovative aspects, so that the person will come to you and buy the product and supply will increase. Number four, how many firms you are having, because of that also the reputation increases. Related good, so you will not have just selected goods. Okay, I am having the Apple industry means only Apple iPhone I have, but not other phone. But when you are the product factory owner, you should have all other goods also. For example, I am doing the farm business means I should have apple, orange, banana, all those items should be there. So if this is not fit for a consumer, he will go for other product, related product. So related good and future good. You should also focus on the future good. What's the next you are going to bring? What the next extra effective you are going to bring? What next innovation you are going to bring? So the supply depends upon the all these factors, such as price of a commodity, price of a labor, price of a capital, state of technology, number of firms, related goods and future goods. So all these aspects brings the supply in an effective way. Let's understand the supply function in a mathematical aspect. Qs is equal to, which means supply function is equal to Px, Pr, Pf, T, O, E. Okay? Px, Pr, Pf, T, O, E. Px is nothing but price of the X commodity. So what the percent, what product you are manufacturing that product, plus PR, related aspect. So other than this product you are doing, what is the other product, that plus FF, price of the factors of production. So the price, the money you have invested in the various factors like land, labor, capital and organization. In those aspects, what you have used. So that one, plus technology, what kind of innovative ideas and ideology you have adopted. So that's one, plus objective of the producer, and what the objective of the producer, what the producer is thinking of, what he is doing for solo business, solo profit, from social activities, so all those activities, and expected price, and what is the expected price in the market. For example, you are selling for 100 rupees, but in the market the price rate expected is 90 only, so you should go for the 90, because market is a well-known aspect. Market knows that where have to be end and where it is going to end. So you should know the expected market price also. So that is what expected price. So you can understand supply function with the help of Px, Pr, Pf, T, O, E, which means price of the commodity, price of the related, price of the factors of production and technology, and expected rate, plus the objective of the firm. When you have this, the supply activities will take in a more effective and appropriate way. Okay, in a simple way, we are doing the supply analysis because we have to know that how the supply is going in the business. That's what we are assuming. Now let's see some of the assumptions, some of the criteria for law of supply. There is no change in the price of factors of production. So one of the major aspect for law of supply is there will be no change in factors of production. Land will be same, labor will be same, same, capital will be same, organization will be same. There will be no changes all the times. From here we are having Chennai, let's move to the Bangalore, let's move to the Kolkata. No, nothing. It will be fixed. Labor, you have the 100 specialized labor, they will be fixed, they only work. Capital, you have a $10,000 as a capital, your $10,000 will remain constant. And the organization, in the particular building, in the Reliance building, if you are having the organization, there should be. So there is no change in the factors of order, whether it's a land, whether it's a labor, whether it's a capital or organization. Nothing change in all these four aspects, okay? Next, no change in the price of capital good. And there is no change in the capital goods. Whatever capital goods you have in the organization, there will be no change. It is totally fixed. Because if you bring change in the capital goods, the supply curve will not have impact. It will go in an inappropriate way. The supply will be get demolished. So that's the reason, no change in the capital goods. Okay? Next, natural resource and their availability remains same. And the natural resource we have, what? Natural resource we have? We have water, we have air, we have land, all these natural resources we have and their availability are same. Natural resource will be same only. It's not going to get over by period of time, right? It's not going to get collapsed. It's not going to have any special effect. So the natural resource and their availability will be remains constant. It will be same. Price is constant. And in the law of supply, price will be also constant. Okay, next one. No change in technology. And in the law of supply, the technology will also will be same only. Because of if there is a change in technology, the innovative ideas will have the impact and it will not turn into a good aspect. No change in the climate. And there is a no change in the climate aspect of individual as a business aspect. So climate change means in the business aspect, the how the work is done, the brotherhoods in the company, how it's working in the organization, how the work is being done. So all these aspects will not get changed. And at the last, no change in the tax policy. So there is a no change in the tax policy also. When hence the tax policy is fixed by the government of India, tax policy fixed by the any country of the board, and they will be same. So assumption are there is a no change in factors of production, no change in the price of capital, no change in the technology, climate, tax policy and natural resources, and their availability remains constant. Okay, thank you.